Good Monday afternoon, everyone. You guys know me, Amy, here with Sandy, and our guest today is David. So we are talking all things current, from business, politics, COVID, anything that's going on, we are going to discuss it. So
taking what they're giving because I'm working for a living.
We've got broken leadership. We have leaders who are not taking care of business. They're more concerned about taking care of themselves and being reelected or getting somebody else to do something. And it's a very a sad day in America to see such selfish, greedy con artists running our country across the board. And it's very unfortunate. The whole situation with COVID-19, I'm sorry, COVID-19 is a pandemic. It is not a political football. And it's unfortunate that we can't seem to find a center ground for administration of COVID-19. And I think even the development of a vaccine, unfortunately, may indeed become a new issue where people are going to just the distribution of the vaccine could indeed become yet another political football on top of so many other political things that should never be politicized being politicized. And again, this is part of the failure of the bureaucratic state. I think one of the overriding concerns that I have is that we've had a situation in America where the bureaucratic state has failed us. I mean, if the Democrats and the Republicans in Congress cannot agree on something as simple as bailing out some of the economically challenged people in America and some of the businesses in America that are in trouble because of politics, that's a failure of the bureaucratic state. That's a failure of the administrative state. So a lot of my topics fit under that. Some of the things I'm concerned about include what I call the new civil war, which is this attempt to take over cities like Portland and Seattle. These are beautiful cities. I've been to both of them. I was in Portland almost exactly 2 years ago for a week from my annual conference. And it was a great city. It was a wonderful place to visit, enjoyed walking around and traveling around different neighborhoods and so forth. And I'm greatly saddened to see the condition of the city and to remember that those are American citizens. Puerto Rico was devastated by a major hurricane several years ago, and yet the death toll was nearly 3,000 people ultimately died from the hurricane that hit Puerto Rico. That's a stunning statistic, and one that indicates that we're not taking care of our business. The people in Puerto Rico are citizens of the United States and need to have, you know, better treatment. But in my book, The Decline of America, 100 Years of Leadership Failures, I made a special effort. Thank you, Sandy. I made a special effort to come up with as independent a sources as we could to find objective facts. And we focused on that. I tried not to include a lot of rumor and innuendo. A good example is an easy one. There was a rumor that Marilyn Monroe and JFK, John F. Kennedy, had a sexual relationship while he was in the White House. It makes great talk. There's absolutely no evidence that that ever happened. Apparently, both of them were fine with the rumor because it increased their halo, if you will, kind of a negative halo, but still a halo. But we couldn't find any evidence that that had happened. George H.W. Bush, as some people call the first President Bush, was rumored that he had a long-term relationship with his personal assistant. And both of them deny that. And there is no objective evidence that we could find that that indeed happened. There are many, many, many accusations against Bill Clinton. During the time that we were writing the book, we could not substantiate things. Clinton, of course, has famously denied ever forcing anybody to have sex with him, but he did settle the Paula Jones lawsuit for an enormous amount of money. I think the settlement was in the $800,000 range.
And I love what you said about rumors. I mean, oh my gosh, that was so dead on. Is like, we don't, and you know, as a citizen, I don't know who to believe and who not to believe these days. And the media, I got that the media gets involved in all that. I get no time.
There's a format to writing. The type of writing that I do is based on fact. And I try to identify sources that are non-political, which is extremely difficult today. Just getting the facts is quite difficult. Of course, famously, one of the early black and white TV shows was Dragnet. And the lead character used to say, "Just the facts, man." And we're having a real hard time in America finding out what just the facts mean. But I'm very hopeful that we will have a female president in the future. I think it is time for the United States to share the leadership. Some of the statistics regarding women include the fact that 55% of college students are female. And the our young men are not being properly raised. They're not being disciplined. And the women are really coming on strong. And the young men out there need to start paying attention. But I do think that just as we're starting to have parity in the legal profession, parity in the accounting profession, we're not there in the hard sciences yet. We're not there in the medical community, but I think the latest medical school statistics show that they're starting to approach male-female parity. So we're making some progress there. That small businesses are not up to date on the federal requirements for COVID-19 accommodation. And so it is very important that small businesses know what they're getting into when they set up a small business. And I find an awful lot of them are operating by the seat of their pants and get in trouble. And most of them do okay, but it's amazing sometimes that you see these stories in the newspaper where a business ends up being fined $250,000 because they just had no clue as to what they were doing in terms of federal or state compliance. So I think that's a big concern. But I think small business in America is the largest employer. It brings people out into the workforce, and it provides an awful lot of opportunities. And remember, things like Facebook and Google and Apple all started as small businesses. So we need to keep growing our economy, and we need to keep encouraging those businesses. And I think one of the things that the Trump administration has done that does help with that is to reduce regulation. We are very, very regulated. A lot of the regulations are contradictory, and many, many businesses actually do not know all of the regulations that apply to their business. So we need to simplify from the government standpoint, make it a little bit easier for businesses to operate. I don't think we're making enough progress in terms of advancement of minorities. And this has nothing to do with the George Floyd protest or any of that. It just has to do with the basic economics. I think we need to increase the emphasis on education in America. For some reason, people are wandering around saying, "Oh, don't worry about that college degree." And that is theoretically true. If you're going to go and become a welder, a plumber, an air conditioning technician, these are wonderful jobs. They pay very well. And if you like working with your hands, then fine. But the majority of jobs are for the educated and for college educated. And one of the funny things is that many plumbers and electricians and these tradesmen and tradeswomen are run their own businesses. And sometimes they have a lot of trouble operating their own business because they don't have the other side of the education that helps them to do the rest of their jobs. So that's kind of an interesting process. But I think education is the key to advancing America beyond where we are today.
I love hearing you answer the questions, and I look forward to this on a weekly basis. As you can see, David is very nonpartisan in his, he has his opinions and will sometimes share them. But for the most part, he's exactly like he said, no rumors, you know, he looks for the facts. And that's what I love about this. So.